Let me illustrate. A podcast series putting the spotlight on board game artists.
My name is Natalia Rojas. I have been a board game artist since 2017, but it's hard to think about myself as a board game artist since I've only worked in one game. I prefer to think I am in the process of becoming a board game artist. I became a board game artist because a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity presented itself when I met the co-founder of Stonemaier Games right when they were looking for a new artist. The art style I am best known for is realism and scientific illustration. The first board game I was an artist for was Wingspan. I am very proud of all the work I've done for Wingspan, and every expansion has taught me something. From the base game, I learned a lot about research and scientific illustration. With the European expansion, I tried to find a good balance between size and detail, but the most challenging one has been the Oceania expansion due to the very intricate birds in Australia and New Zealand. I like creating artwork that has a meaning behind it, that tells a story of something special. I work from photo references, so I am attracted to just simple, beautiful images. I get my inspiration from nature, of course, but also from meaningful moments or objects. I like to draw simple things that will tell a story or bring back a memory. I think one of the most important parts of making artwork for a board game is precision, because you have to make sure the art aligns with the theme on the board game. I think the most challenging part of making artwork for board game is timing, because there can be tight deadlines to meet, and illustration is not a speedy process. It can take me from 8 to 36 hours to draw the art for just one card. The longest I worked on art for a board game was for the Oceania expansion. It took me around 10 months to complete my part because I decided to work on a larger scale to include more detail. In my view, more board game artwork should continue to embrace different art styles, but also be more inclusive to women and people of color in the industry. The artists whose style I admire the most are Ana Maria Martinez and Beth Sobel, but I like many other artists that don't work on board games art, like Jonah Dry and Ileana Hunter. My favorite colors are red, white, and black. What very few people know about me is that I often, if not always, imagine my memories and thoughts in some form of childish cartoons. If you wanted to become a board game artist yourself, I would tell you, reach out to board game creators and work on your portfolio. If you want to get in touch, you can reach me at my website, nataliarojasart.com, and also my social media as Natalia Rojas Art as well.
This podcast was made possible by the generous help of my Patreon supporters, Royal Patron Sean Newman, Castle Guard David Miller, Dice Masters Alex Bardi, Paul Grogan, Robin Kay and James Naylor, and Shining Lights Sarah Reed, Tim Vernick, and Weird Wizards.